Hello everyone, welcome back to iLLPHOCORPHICS. In today's tutorial, I will show you how can you create this awesome concrete wall image editing effect in Photoshop. This is really an awesome editing technique that you can use your own image to create this effect, and I hope that it will look awesome. So watch the tutorial carefully until the end, and learn how can you also create this awesome image editing technique in Photoshop. Don't forget to tell me your valuable word in the comment section below. Leave a like, and subscribe if you didn't yet. Not just subscribe, also press the bell icon, so that you get all the notification of my new tutorials when I upload. Also, I have an announcement to the end of this tutorial. Or you can check this time to watch the announcement. Be sure to watch the announcement. So let's start today's tutorial. Now we are here in the magical world of Photoshop. I have downloaded this wall background image, also other images that I will use this tutorial. If you want to download all these images, you can check the link in the description. Now first, we will create that concrete wall image effect. So go to the first model image document. Now we need to make a selection and remove the background. Go to the toolbar, and take the quick selection tool. Take your time and make the selection as perfect as possible. Now we make the selection. Next, we need to refine the edges of the model. To refine the edges, you can use the CC version Refine Edge. But I will use the older version of the Refine Edge. To find the older version of Refine Edge, go to the Select, then Select and Mask. Before clicking here, press Shift on your keyboard, then click. It will open the older version of the Refine Edge. Zoom in. Now again take your time and refine the edges properly. After that, increase the contrast a little bit. Adjust the feather. Select the output as a new layer with layer mask. Hit OK. Now we remove the background from the model. Next, take the model and paste it to the main composition. Zoom out. Press Ctrl or Command plus T to open Free Transform. Make the model image size smaller and match the image size with the wall background. Delete the layer mask. Select Apply. Go to the Layers panel, press the right button on your mouse, and convert into Smart Object. Next, we will apply the effect to create that concrete wall image effect. To do that, go to the Filter, and Filter Gallery. Zoom out. Apply the Poster Edges effect. Now adjust the effect with these sliders. See what's perfect for your image. Now hit OK. Zoom in. Change the blending mode into the overlay. Now you can see it's matched with the background wall. Next, we will make more adjustments to the image so that it's matched this with wall and look realistic. Apply a layer mask to the image, go to the toolbar, and take the brush tool. Be sure the foreground color is black, and remove the bottom part. Now that's okay. Next, decrease the fill. Then go to the adjustment layer, and take hue, saturation adjustment. Decrease the saturation. Again adjust the fill. Now, that's okay. Next, we will add the feather and text effect to the wall. Go to the feather image document. Take the image and paste it to the main composition. Put it to the corner, and press Ctrl or Command plus T to open Free Transform. Make the size bigger. Hit OK. Change the blending mode into the overlay. Go to the toolbar, and take the horizontal type tool. We will add a simple text to the wall. Click to the left side. Make the text size bigger. And write a line. You can choose as you like. Open the character setting. If you don't find it here, go to Window, Character. Now we will make some adjustments to the text. First, change the text style into Mistral. Change the text color into black. Increase text size. Decrease the text gap into 0. Then again increase the text size. Adjust the text and put the text into a perfect place. Go to the Layers panel. Press the right button on your mouse, and convert to Smart Object. Change the blending mode into the overlay. Decrease the fill around 70%. Next, we will add our model to the composition. Go to the Model Image document. Now we need to make the selection again to remove the background. Go to the toolbar, and take a quick selection tool. Adjust the size and select the model. Take your time and select the model properly. Zoom in. Adjust the brush size, press Alt or Option on your keyboard and deselect this area. Take your time and make the selection as perfect as you can. Now that's okay. Next, we will refine the edges. Go to the Select, then select Unmask. Before click, press Shift on your keyboard and click. Now again take your time and refine the edges of the model. Increase the feather. Select the output as a new layer with layer mask. Hit OK. Take the move tool. Zoom out. Take the image, and paste it to the main composition. Take the layer to the top. Press Ctrl or Command plus T to open the free transform. And make the image size smaller. Make some adjustments, and put the model to the right side. Hit OK. Now there are some edges we need to remove. Take the brush tool. Select the layer mask, and remove the edges. That's OK. Take the move tool. Delete the layer mask. Select apply. Next, we will create a shadow to the model. Select the model image layer, and press Ctrl or Command plus J to make a duplicate layer. Invisible the first layer. Press Ctrl or Command then click to the thumbnail of the model layer. It will make a selection. Then press Alt or Option plus Backspace to fill the selection with the foreground color. Press Ctrl or Command plus D to deselect. Visible the model image. Select shadow layer, press Ctrl or Command plus T to open Free Transform. Then go to the point of Free Transform. Press Ctrl or Command and take the shadow to the right side. Then open the Wrap tool, and make some adjustments to the shadow. Hit OK. Change the blending mode into Soft Light. Then go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Adjust the blur. Hit OK. Now decrease the fill of the shadow. Zoom in. Go to the toolbar, and take the brush tool. Create a blank layer, adjust the brush size, and create a shadow to the bottom of the foot. change the blending mood into soft light. Then again adjust the shadow. That's okay. Zoom out. Take the move tool. Now we will make the color adjustment to match the model with the background. Go to the adjustment layer. And take the curve tool. Then go to the properties, select the black eyedrop, and click to the black of the image. Then take gray eyedrop tool and click to the gray area of the image. Then again take white eyedrop tool, and click to the white area of the image. It will collect sample and apply color adjustment to the image. Take your time and follow my step to make the color adjustment. Now that's okay. Next, create a blank layer. Then go to Edit, Fill. Now fill it with 50% gray. Hit OK. Change the blending mood into soft light. Go to the toolbar, and take Burn tool. Adjust the brush size. Take your time and apply the burn effect to the model edge. And also add burn other sides where you like to add. That's okay. Take the move tool. Again click to the curve adjustment. Now adjust the color correction again. Take your time and make the adjustment. Next, we will create a snapshot of the layers. Select the first layer, and press Shift plus Ctrl plus Alt plus E to create that snapshot. If you are using Mac, then press Shift plus Command plus Option plus E to create a snapshot from all the layers. Press the right button on your mouse, and convert to Smart Object. Go Filter, then Camera or Filter. Now you can just follow my step. Or if you like to download the color grading preset, you can check the link in the description. So just follow my step, and give the final color grading touch to your composition. Here we will create our vignette. I have a very good trick to give the vignette. First, decrease the amount, 100, decrease the feather 0. Now you can adjust the midpoint of the vignette. Then increase the feather 100, and adjust the amount. Increase the highlight. Go to basic adjustment, and give the final touch to your editing. Now that's okay. I am happy with that. Hit OK. Now you can see the before color grading and after color grading. Now that's done. I just want to show you all the process of editing this concrete wall image editing effect. Let's see our final output. Now, I just show you all the processes to edit this awesome image editing. I try to explain all the tricks and methods so that you can use this method and create this kind of editing with your own image. I have an announcement. Making videos is very hard. I am facing lots of problems, and I need your support to keep my working on YouTube. So, I have created a Patreon account. If you like my work and want to support my channel to keep my working, so please support me through Patreon. And I hope you like this tutorial. If you like this tutorial, you can also check out my other tutorials on my channel. I hope you will also like and learn something new. Don't forget to tell me what do you think about tutorials and my channel in the comments below. Leave a like on this video, and subscribe if you didn't yet. Not just subscribe, Also press the bell icon, so that you get all the notifications of my new tutorials when I upload. And don't miss any new tutorial to learn new things about Photoshop. So that's it for today. See you in my next tutorial. Till then, bye. And the most important thing, keep learning.